Welcome to this brief guide on how to make your own custom emoji in Slack. Reacting to my colleagues' messages in Slack is something that I do multiple times a day, but sometimes I can't find just the right emoji for my needs. So today I'm going to show you how you can create your own custom emoji to use as needed. Here you can see I'm inside my Slack client, and if I head down to the text compose field here, you can see the emoji button. Selecting this is going to give me a pop-up where I can see all of the available emojis inside my Slack workspace. And there are lots of them, literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. But if I can't find just the right one for my needs, I can use an image and create my own. So the first thing I'll need to do is get the image that I would like to use as my emoji. And for that, I'm going to actually head to Google, and I'm going to show you a brand new feature in Google called the Emoji Kitchen. So by doing a simple Google search for the term Emoji Kitchen, I'll get a pop-up right at the top of the search results with a big button at the bottom there that says Get Cooking. Selecting this is going to give me a wide selection of emojis, and you'll see at the top here I have a box where I can select Randomize to get my very own random emoji mashup, which will be a mix of any two of the emojis from the box below. But if I wanted to, I could individually select any of these emojis, or I can actually use the dice button underneath any of the emoji to get a randomly selected one. That shocked bird looks pretty funny. And if I wanted to, I can select individual emojis for both of them and create my very own custom emoji. So here I've selected mind blown and a koala, and now I have a mind blown koala emoji. I select the button underneath the emoji at the end to copy it, and now it's in my clipboard. I need to save it somehow so that I can then use it. Luckily, Slack can do that for me. So I'm going to simply paste this down in a message to myself, and I've sent it there, and there is my image ready to use. So I can then simply hover over it and use Slack to download and save this image to my computer. Now that I've got it there, how do I set it as an emoji? Well, that's easy enough to do. I simply select the emoji option here to get my emoji flyout, and I'm going to select the button that says Add Emoji. And from the pop-up that we get, it'll give us some information to let us know that ideally we should be using a square image with a transparent background that is quite small in size. Luckily, the image we just downloaded meets both of those needs perfectly. So we'll select Upload Image and then choose our image file from our computer's file manager. Then once we've selected it, in this case we're going to choose Open, and now we have our image there. And we can see in the preview here what this emoji is going to look like in both light mode and in dark mode. And then we head down to the second section here, and now we simply need to give our emoji a name. In my case, I'm going to call this Mind Blown Koala. If you'd prefer to, you can use hyphens or underscores to split these words up, but please note that you cannot use spaces. It does need to be a single phrase. In my case, I'm just going to leave it as one word saying Mind Blown Koala. Once we've got our name sorted, we can then simply click on the Save button in the corner here, and now we have our custom emoji saved. In order to utilize it, we can select the reaction option just like we normally would, and we can then use the search field at the top of all of our emoji, start beginning to type in that name, and there you can see I have my mind blown koala emoji. I can simply select it in order to utilize it, and now that it's inside the workspace, all of my colleagues can utilize it too. And if you'd like to see all of the custom emoji that are available in your space, simply use the emoji flyout and select the Slack icon at the end, and you'll be able to see all of the custom emoji that have been added by both yourself and also your colleagues. And that is how you create and use your very own custom emoji in Slack. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.